The use of Sharia or Islamic religious law is growing in Britain. Each year, thousands of Muslims choose it to settle disputes. But Sharia councils don't have any legal powers and only deal with civil matters. And many people think they discriminate against women and that two systems of justice shouldn't be allowed. Inside Out has been given exceptional access inside a council and a tribunal, both where Sharia law is used.
You know, whether you really do want to a
rare glimpse into what is normally a hidden world. Sharia law.
Happy to move forward with it.
She reported to the police that he was trying to kill her.
For Muslims, Sharia is a path which leads to justice.
Sharia rules and laws are designed to regulate correctly, properly, and comfortably the lives of Muslims throughout the world.
But for opponents, it's a dangerous road to a parallel system of justice which should be outlawed.
They're ruling on family law and criminal law matters, which are reserved for UK courts.
The perception of Sharia law is that it encourages brutal punishments, such as the sentences of lashes and stonings handed out in the Middle East. But Muslims here say their idea of justice is very different.
I myself get very worried when I see Sharia being misrepresented by the actions of these evil people in the Middle East who claim to be implementing Sharia and the laws of Islam. Actually, they're not. What they're doing is barbaric.
We understand this is the first.
The Sharia Council at the Central Mosque in Birmingham is used each year by hundreds of people from the East and West Midlands.
Because if he's giving her divorce, then he has no right to take anything back from her. That's the Islamic regulations. If a man divorces a woman, he has no right to anything that he's given her.
She reported to the police that he was trying kill her. Take her.
The case has gone through. He wasn't found guilty, so she is obviously not interested in this marriage.
Islamic scholars and academics listen to applicants, call witnesses, study the written evidence, and then give their verdict.
All the evidence before us, we come to the conclusion that this marriage is to be dissolved from today. And Islamically, we have to help people who are in need and who have problems. To make peace between people is very important. So it's an obligation on a Muslim community to help resolve those problems, and that's why the Sharia councils were set up.
Many Muslims have marriages which aren't recognised in Britain because they've never been registered. This means women have no legal right to financial support.
Husbands are mostly reluctant to let their wives go. Despite their own shortcomings, they refuse to give talaq. Talaq is divorce. And that's where the Sharia councils, committees, come into action.
Sharia councils can't deal with criminal cases. This council handles mostly simple divorce and family matters. But opponents of Sharia say some councils go beyond their remit.
Councils are operating a parallel legal system. They're ruling on family law and criminal law matters, which are reserved for UK courts. What that means in reality is that they're ruling on domestic violence dispute, when there may be allegations of rape. They're ruling on child residence and contact matters, which again should be reserved for UK courts.
Many Muslim women see Sharia councils as their only way of escaping a violent or loveless marriage. This woman in her 20s went to a Sharia council after suffering 7 years of violent abuse.
My husband broke my thumb and hit me many times. He once threw me down the stairs. Without an Islamic divorce, I would still be tied to my husband. Now he has no power over me. I'm so happy they gave me a divorce and I'm finally free.
Rafia Arshad specialises in family law in Nottingham. She says banning Sharia would leave many women trapped in failed marriages.
Sharia councils or courts are necessary in this country because it's the only place a Muslim woman can get a Islamic divorce. If a couple want to end their marriage, either it's done through the husband who pronounces talaq, or the wife would need to go through a Sharia council or Sharia court to get something called a khulla. So a khulla is something that's obtained by the Muslim woman, but it can only be given through a Sharia council, and that's why it's necessary in this country.
At some Sharia councils, getting a divorce isn't straightforward. Inside Out spoke to one woman who moved away with her three children to escape her violent husband. She still lives in terror of him and asked not to be filmed. She gave us this statement.
I was 16 when I married, and I was in a violent relationship for 13 years. I went to a Sharia council for a khulla, or divorce. They kept saying we should try for reconciliation, and we had to meet face to face. I said, I'm not doing that, no way. I felt they were taking his side. It was 2 years before I was finally given a divorce.
Often in situations of domestic violence, women are encouraged to return home to their abusive husband, as opposed to seeking legal advice from a UK court or even from the police. They're discouraged from going to the police, leaving them in very vulnerable situations where they're open to further abuse and domestic violence.
Is there anybody in particular on your side that you refer to for counselling or for help?
Just outside Hinckley in Leicestershire, at Hijaz College, despite the traditional setting, there's a more modern interpretation of Sharia law. This is the Muslim Arbitration Tribunal, which can deal with both financial and divorce cases. The chairman is a barrister and an Islamic scholar, and everyone on the panel is a lawyer.
The foundation of your claim is that husband's on drug addiction at the moment. And he's also sort of being physically violent as well. Essentially, we ensure that the disputes are resolved through the Arbitration Act in a manner in which is compliant with the Sharia and with English law as well. So there's actually no conflicts between the two.
Discrimination against women is one of the main complaints against Sharia councils. But both the Central Mosque and the Muslim Arbitration Tribunal say there's always at least one woman on their panels. But that isn't the case everywhere else.
Sharia councils are undoubtedly, on the whole, run by men for men. What I mean by that is that the rulings that they make are gender discriminatory. They often require two male Muslim witnesses to confirm a woman's version of events, yet a man does not have to bring along two male Muslim witnesses to confirm his evidence.
Where did you seek medical help?
My thoughts and opinions are given equal importance and weight. And this is particularly the case where, for example, a case involves women, such as divorce or cases of a sensitive nature. It must also be noted that I am very much a part of the proceedings as much as the other panellists.
A Ministry of Justice inquiry in 2011 had to be abandoned because of a lack of cooperation by Sharia councils. But the Birmingham Mosque and Muslim Arbitration Council say they provide an essential service for Muslims and they have nothing to hide.
Well, they're not two systems of justice. They're complementary with each other. Like, for example, the Beth Din has been operating in this country for the Jewish community for the last 110 years. We can't police your home for you. You know, we can only arbitrate, we can only mediate. This is one of those extra services which we're offering to at least 3.5 million Muslims in this country.
The government says all religious rulings are subject to British law, and that won't change. But concerns remain, and as part of its extremism strategy, the government has ordered a wide-ranging review into Sharia law, and that could lead to much tighter regulation.